No?
We put it like
the site plan at a different layer than the floor plan and the elevations. So the elevations and the sections are around the ground floor, so the floor plan in the file. So, and on Main Street, you can find several buildings with good shops and housing.
One question on this section.
Yeah.
Are you sure that this?
Yeah, this is a different roof. Yeah.
This is like.
But we assume.
You can see it from the shots. Yeah.
No, see the where the cut is.
Yeah.
In the plan.
Yes.
There, yeah. The roof is like this.
Okay. That if you suppose a roof, you can suppose a structure too. It's not that we don't know and then we do no suppositions. Do some kind of supposition. So our trust should be that.
We have the detail, we just didn't communicate.
Okay.
So here in this section we showed like the beams and the construction for the water pipes and like all the internals as well. This is the part that belongs also to the big main hall. Then in the elevation, from the south you can see all the like shops and houses, and this is the part that is like belongs to the old hall, but it has a different facade. So we think that the facade came later. The elevation from the east, so this is the main entrance to the big hall, and these are the buildings that belong to the ancient hall. So this is the big door where you can go inside. And in the other elevations, you can see that the construction with the columns of the big hall. And this is also the part that belongs to the big hall, where you can go through stairs. So, details?
We have a detail of the units
of the rear with a wall. That's what, sorry. We can see the units of the beam with a photo, the drop. And then we have the columns of the main structure that all have the same size.
Section,
sorry. And we have the second structure.
Secondary
structure. That, well, is it? Well, we have an exception.
You can ask the special effects of, you know, the special effects don't do that. But sonido de intermedio is only that.
Okay, sorry. Exception principal structure, who have a beam that make it for a big door, and the water system detail that sometimes is in the outside.
Water drain.
Drain? Okay. Drain? There. It's outside the wall and sometimes inside.
Well, we missed the other detail of the water drain inside. This is on the outside, right? Go back.
Yeah. It's.
Because that's not the detail we're seeing on the right.
Okay. And then an additional dimension. And here it's the structure of the entrance.
Now you know.
Yeah. That's got a different type of structure. Well, here we go. Yesterday to a warehouse that's called Eventos, and the structure is very different. It's only have a main structure.
Trust.
Yeah. Here we have the pro and the details.
And what I can add to this last part, when we call it construction stage 1 and construction stage 2, because we found out that it seems like this is one hole, and it's also inside it's connected this way. We will add it to the floor plans. But so this building is connected as one building inside, and this is like a separate building. So here's a brick wall, and but as we were looking at the details, we found out that here it's like a truss of 5 meters between the beams. And we were wondering, okay, here it's the same, and then starting here, it's like a new, there's a stage 2, how we call it. And then later we went to this part, and we saw, okay, it's the same details as in this part. So this one must have been there first, and then they added this connection to connect the hole to Pellegrini. And also from here, from inside, you can see the facade of this building where they closed the windows. So you have the same shape of the windows as in this facade, but here they closed it. So this has been there, this must have been there first, then they added this part, and in the end they added this part. And here, in the ground floor, there's a little door in the wall, and you can go underneath the earth, and here's a tunnel to the cemetery. But
what?
This will be, there's a tunnel to the cemetery from this place to there. And the people who work there.
You need a tunnel to the cemetery.
And the people, the people who work here, they think that in former times they used to build the boxes for the dead people.
Features where you can separate or do something. If you don't spend some time trying to understand how all these clusters got together, you're going to miss some possible integrations that take into account the lines that are crossing in the cluster. So this is very important work where you try to find out what came first, what came afterwards.
Sorry, could you repeat the name you said in Sony? The name of
Solvruchstätten.
Was? Das Wort? Size of the trees?
Yeah,
part, this like this base part, was added later, because we thought that these windows went through, as they were planned, they went through to the ground, and this part was added later. So these gates and these door and windows were also added later.
Why do you think that?
Because in the plans we got, it looks differently than the things we measured when we were there. And yeah, this part looks like really different than this brick part. On this side you can see the construction and the set with beams. And here you can see the other buildings with the like the other typology of buildings. And yeah, here we show you the different layers we created. So we made like really basic layers, not have so much layers in the CAD file. Supporting walls, columns, beams, these are the main structure of the building. And then we have the extension walls, internals, rails and stairs, which you could remove if you like.
Okay, so we looked at the details of the block B. The general structure is maybe not that in comparison to block A, less complicated. So we got the floors. There's more like a new board about different types of materials we found. Of course, you have some that are originally older and some that I just got rid of towards. We looked at the walls actually. In general, you have found out that this is a steel structure and this is a structure made of bricks. Also, the walls here around the steel structures are also all made of bricks. We didn't find any concrete anywhere, just brick. So we can see it's actually always. Brick covered with and the masonry is always for all masonries we found where in the section here we always have a long one and the depth, so we have like 27.5 and then two in the other direction, and that is actually always the basic structure of all walls we found. In terms of ceilings in the first part here, there are no ceilings, that's interesting. Here we have also this construction, which we also think is steel beams, and then also the construction. But you only find this in the first part. So then the most interesting thing is the construction of those barrel shaped roofs. First of all, the most interesting thing we found out at the beginning is that every bearing construction piece is not a steel, like not a common steel piece, but it's a railway. So it was very hard to take pictures, but this is a railway, and this is another railway. And also the beams are railways, and also the arms are railways. So
are you sure about that?
Question.
You understood?
Yeah, I've never seen something like that before. It's I don't know. It's quite interesting. So these are two wooden rings attached to each other. The beam is very very and the arc is very interesting. Yeah, so here's the basic construction. We already talked about that. So then we looked at the details. First of all, the junction, yeah, at this point. So you have, this is a sketch of a railway. It's not a train rail, but a tram, tram rail. Also the trams that are here, metro in the city. And so you have those two here also attached to each other, and you have a corbel in this area.
What's the name?
Corbel?
Corbel?
Yeah. And then another up to here where you put the beam, and then one piece of construction that joins the two, like the arch, attaches the arch to the beam, and here, the weight goes all over these two columns. We couldn't take measurements because obviously it was too far up from the sky. Then we have some more details, like this and the flat steel here, attached to the arch to the beams. That's the measurements. Take off and measure this would be a column, cut through a column. They are just attached with we can also see, at some points it already moves quite a bit, it already has a shape, so can't really trust it. And then you have this would be the arc, and this the beam underneath, and it's attached to a flat steel element. And also here, this part here, sometimes the beam does go all the way through, but at some points it's just one rail and here and one there, and it's next to each other. The roof we found, it's also this structure that you see everywhere. Either it's a bit pretty see through, so the light gets through, and sometimes it's not transparent. And the idea is that sometimes you have a bit more light. At some points, the ventilation lights only work here on the roof. Yeah, basic structure. This is not a railway, it's a double L profile attached to each other. Openings, you have different kinds. Some are maybe worth keeping, some maybe not. This construction of the window is quite interesting. Because you have a real big wheel here that is turning the steel element that is opening all the elements at once. It's quite interesting to see. Then you have lots of installations that are some quite improvised. I really like the detail of what are going through the wall. It's sometimes they sometimes here you see them where the two arcs connect. You also have a water drain over here, and then a block pipe over down. So that's the basic structure. And of course, you already found lots of interventions that are not in the image. Well, they are. You obviously see that they are way later, and we didn't take details about that. You see it was some parts technical installations or those interventions, but in some parts in the street house in front and the old house, you also see that some changes were made in the process.
Okay. Any questions? You know, the German way is more efficient. You need only one hand, and you can do whatever you want with the other one. Still, express your support.
So for the details of the part which we just visited yesterday, with the knowledge of the building, we also saw the rails there, and also the
Casatonics. Bóveda is a vault, and in Spanish, everything that follows with ilia, bóvedilla is a small vault.
So they have the same construction there. So maybe the block B and the other building they will build at the same time.
Well, this is a very traditional way of doing roofs, so it doesn't mean that they were built at the same time.
Because they're just the using the rails and
it's the rail company. Okay. Maybe they have rails very cheap. They don't need to buy new ones.
Yeah, and also there was a tramway in Rosario. There was a tramway in Rosario, so maybe some of those rails could have belonged to the tramway.
Of course. Yeah. That's why. That's kind of, yeah. Buildings and you can share it after.
and all the layers and look what you need. You can hide everything. You see everywhere is the structure to see. And for the trees, we decide to take trees like this, pipes, two pipes, just to blend a little bit in the background.
There are two kinds of trees. One they are quite bigger than other ones, so we make kind of.
Let's not spend too much time on the trees.
Okay, then.
Thank you very much for trees and staying on buildings.
Yeah, that's it for at all.
But you didn't get it in time, the information from Laila about the trusses on the second hall.
No, outside.
Yeah. And, but we are in Buenos Aires on the weekend, but you're staying here.
It's fun for the Germans.
And we did
We have to give Emre a couple of minutes on this, otherwise he's going to be very frustrated.
No, I didn't edit.
You see?
I didn't edit it now, but
oh, it's not edited.
No, it's not. It's just a summarizing of the pictures that I did.
Nobody's swimming.
I did so many pictures. This is just a video. We can cut this video too. It's in 4K, so you have. Oh.
RI, which is the chair. this is our folder organization. Each image is, has a code, as Kilian showed you, and is divided like, into the exterior. So you can see on the side how is the code. Into the exterior, and it's divided into the block. Or yeah, maybe it's
if it's
organized in the block. Then if it's the area or the street, if it's good. And then we have divided into details, general pictures, elevations, panorama images, and the aerial or the drone images. Then we got the numbers. You can always, if you have the image, you can show it the code, and you will always find its source afterwards. And so here are some examples for the images. We have the code, for example, inside block A, part 02, and then PN for panorama, and then the number. For the outside images, for example, outside, block B, then street code name, so the code for the street name, detail, DT, and then the number.
Don't underestimate the necessity of a structure if you're in your pictures folder. Because we have in the office sometimes a folder or whatever, and there are 200 pictures inside there, and you don't have the time to find what you're looking for because it's not structured at all. And it's really a disaster. So any structure is saving time if you're looking, going back to your pictures. Maybe not now for your conceptual approaches, but in reality, and for anything else, the structure is fundamental.
So we made a really brief selection of pictures. For the outside pictures, we have four categories. First ones are the aerial pictures Emre took. So this is the example for that. Then we got perspectives. We selected some of them and like straightened the light and changed the light a little bit so that we can use them to Photoshop or do renders. So this is a view from Riccieri to block A. This is the view from Montevideo to Baccia, like the corner, to block A. Then we went at night, but we only took like some pictures for like the general atmosphere. This is the yard, which is also like in like outside pictures categorized because it could be confusing because it's like the inner space of the block. And then we did like elevations from the street. They're not as precise as the drawings, of course, but they're meant to be like like show an atmosphere of the whole street. And we even put the block next to it to show the surrounding environment. And then we took detailed pictures. I think that's it for the outside pictures.
Yes, one desired sample of the interior images. For example, this is the block B, elevation 2. It's a sample of general images.
It's the second thing.
And this is another sample of general image. But this is an example of detail in block A. And this is the panorama picture. Of course, there is also a 360 degree image, which Simon is going to show.
So when you think about it, it's always very hard to just have a photo with 100 photos, detailed photos, to know exactly where we took the photo afterwards. So we decided to take these 360 degree images. So you can open this with this very well-known freeware media player, or you can, and there are other possibilities. There's a lot of freeware we can download to open these 360 degree images, or you can just import them into your rendering programs as background, for example, if you want to. Renderings. I can first quickly show you how we open these images. For example, you have this image. We have them in low resolution, we show them in the media player, and we have them in high resolution if you want to to render these points. You can just open this with the media player, and you have to press pause, and then you can take the mouse to look around. So it's always easier if you have the 360 degree image, if you're searching for a special image, you don't know exactly where to put. We have, in each block, we have four 360 degree images, so we hope that you can see them in the course.
In some abstract way, and in this phase, in this level of start to think about concepts, you should switch really from many of them, because you can see, for example, people who were thinking only with the model in front of them, or thinking, people who were thinking only with the axonometry and playing with the ideas only through the axonometry notation. You should switch, and especially you can see on this phase. Checking what you're doing conceptually, trying to imagine the space and see what happens if I do what I'm trying to do. Because the notations, they give you a feedback that's every time different. And it's very often that you project in axonometry, or you design in model, and you don't design being inside the rooms. So I would recommend that you always try to check when you're making an operation, whatever, in a very abstract way in an axonometry, to have the photographs just in the computer or prints of the computer, and check what would happen, what I'm doing, if I would be the person and then you're inside the room. You have a great material. You could, for example, make a transparent sketch on top of the photograph and then try things on axonometry and then go back to the photography and see what I'm really talking about, because the final perception of architecture is not the axonometry, but you being in the space. And sometimes many things doesn't look abstract in the notations, axonometry doesn't look good because you are judging according to the aesthetics of the notation, but could be great if you are inside in the